Okay, now let me continue with the chapter before we continue with the text, reading of the text. Yesterday we have reached the point in the story where we realize that the Englishman who was injured badly, there was a bullet hit on his back, he was bleeding badly, he was in a pathetic condition, he was taken care by Dr. Sadow. Dr. Sadow brought him to his home. He made him comfortable. He asked Hannah to ask one of the caretakers or one of the servants to clean the wound. The caretaker of the children, Yumi, see, she was asked by Hannah to clean the wound, but Yumi denied. All the servants, the cook, the gardener, Yumi, the caretaker, they were against the notion that their boss had brought this Englishman at his home, and he was treating him, he was curing him, right? So they were all against it, and they had decided to leave the house also for that, right? Now, because Yumi had denied for that, so Hannah had to clean the wound. She cleaned the wound. So in the initially she was really very scared while doing so, but she did that. And then Dr. Sudhar realized that the surgery had to be done immediately. The bullet had to be taken out. So he started with the surgery. Hannah, who was there, she saw so much blood and everything. So she was feeling very sick. So she ran out into the garden. She vomited and then she came back. Right. So that was the point where we had done. So I'm starting from this one. Just a second. Okay, let's start from this. As for Sadow, every day he examined the wound carefully. So you have to start from this point. No, sorry. Okay, this is the servant's view. We are going to start from this point. That young master is so proud of his skill to save life that he saves any life, the cook said contemptuously. We are going to start from this stanza. Harshita, please read 2-3 stanzas, then I'm going to give the explanation side by side. Shall we start? Harshita, shall we start? Is my voice audible to you? Harshita, please respond back. Can you hear me? Okay, please start reading. The young master is so proud of his skill. Harshita, your voice has started lagging. Some technical issue. Ek bar check karo, beta. Harshita, I think I need to give somebody else the permission to read. Some technical issue with Harshita. Harshita, ek bar try kar lena. Shubhangi, you can read it from your end. The network is okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'm giving you the permission. Pitch high but pace slow, please.
Yes, ma'am.
चलिए इज द स्क्रीन विजिबल टू यू
यस मैम
प्लीज स्टार्ट रीडिंग
द यंग मास्टर इज सो प्राउड ऑफ हिज स्किल टू सेव लाइफ दैट ही सेव्स एनी लाइफ द कुक सेड कंटेम्पिटियसली शी स्प्लिट अ फाउल्स नेक स्किलफुली and held the fluttering bird and let its blood flow in the roots of the wistaria vine. Blood is the best of fertilizers, and the old gardener would not let her waste a drop of it.
Okay, so this is general. The gardeners, I told you, the cook and the gardener, they were discussing about that the boss is very happy to cure the patients, whosoever they are. Right? So they were discussing about that thing only. Okay. Shubhangi, please continue.
It is the children of whom, ma'am, please scroll up. It's the children of whom we must think, Yumi said sadly. What will be their fate if their father is condemned as a traitor? They did not try to hide what they said from the ears of Hana as she stood arranging the day's flower in the veranda nearby. And she knew they spoke on purpose that she might hear. That they were right, she knew too in the most of her being. But there was another part of her which herself could not understand. It was not sentimental liking of the prisoner. She had...
Sorry guys, just a second. Continue, please.
She had come to think of him as a prisoner. She had not liked him even yesterday when he had said in his impulsive way. Anyway, let me tell you that my name is Tom. She had only bowed her little distant bow. She saw hurt in his eyes and she did not wish to assert it. Indeed, he was great trouble in this house.
So here we understand how they were feeling. They were not comfortable having this man at the home because he was not generally a patient. He was an enemy patient, right? Staunch enemy and a patient too. So that was their trouble. And the coming of that man into the house, so they both the husband and wife, they took the decision to bring him to the house. And he need to go that immediate medical treatment and the surgery and everything. But still, there was a sort of discomfort in the house because everybody was against that notion of bringing that enemy into the house. So that is, we see Hana, who had to do everything, she was doing it. Perhaps, again, that conscious compulsion was there. Right? Nobody was compelling them, but that conscious compulsion, you understand? Their conscience was not allowing them being a doctor, being into this noble profession and leaving a person who is dying to let him die. They had to take care of him, right? So she had not liked him even yesterday when she had said in this impulsive day. So now a day has passed, his surgery has been done. Anyway, let me tell you that my name is Tom. She had only bowed a little distant bow. She saw hurt in his eyes, but she did not wish to assuage it. Assuage it means reduce it or by any means talk to him and trying to console him. She was not interested in all that stuff, right? So his name was Tom. Now he was in a condition that he could talk. He was fine now. Right, and she understood very well that this newcomer, this patient who is being treated right now, is a trouble for the house. Right, please continue, Shubhangi. Shubhangi, yes, just give me a second. Okay, you may continue.
As for Sadao, every day he examined the wound carefully. The last stitches had been pulled out this morning, and the young man would in a fortnight be nearly as well as ever. Sadao went back to his office and carefully typed a letter to the chief of police reporting the whole matter. On the 21st of February, an escaped prisoner was washed up on the shore in front of my house. So far, he typed, and then he opened a secret drawer on his office desk and put the unfinished report into it.
Right now, Sadao was actually desperately waiting that when would his wounds heal up so that he can throw away that man out of his house. The last stitches had been pulled out this morning, and the young man would be in a fortnight, be nearly as well as ever. So the stitches were removed now. He would be in a position to stand up or walk. At least he'll be much better. Now, Sudhao went back to his office and carefully typed a letter to the chief of the police reporting the whole matter. So Sudhao made up his mind that he'd be reporting the entire thing to the police. He started writing the report. And he just started on the 21st day of February. An escaped prisoner was washed up on the shore in front of my house. But then something stopped him from informing the police. And he again put the incomplete report, unfinished report, back into the drawer of his cabinet. Please continue.
On the seventh day after that, two things happened. In the morning, the servants left together their belongings tied in a large square cotton kerchiefs. When Hannah got up in the morning, nothing was done. The house was not cleaned and the food not prepared. She knew what it meant. She was dismayed and even terrified, but her pride as a mistress would not allow her to show it. Instead, she inclined her head gracefully when they appeared before her in the kitchen. And she paid them off and thanked for all that they had done for her. They were crying, but she did not cry. The cook and the gardener had served Sudhao since he was a little boy in his father's house, and Yumi cried because of the children. She was so grieving that after she had done, she ran back to Hannah.
Now, this is basically that several days have passed, but still that Englishman is in their house. Now, the servants in the beginning, they just opposed. Now they have decided to leave the house, right? And the servants somewhere, they were very much connected to the house because the servants perhaps were living in this house for quite a long time. Their father, Sudhao's father, had hired it. So Yumi was really very upset. So Hannah, being the mistress of the house, she didn't show her emotions, but even she was feeling bad when the servants were leaving. So she paid them off and thanked them for all their duties. The servants were crying and they warned that the mistress or their master should stop them and should tell them that you do not go away. We are going to send this man away. But that didn't happen, right? So the servants were crying, but Hannah, being a strong lady and being the mistress, she didn't express her emotions at all. The cook and the gardener had served Sudhao since he was a little boy, and Yumi cried because of the children. Yumi, as she was the caretaker of the children, she was connected to the children. So she cried because she was getting away from the, separated from the children. She was so grieving that after she had gone, she ran back to Hannah. That even when she had gone, she came back to Hannah. And then she tells that if the baby misses me too much tonight, send for me. That if the babies miss me too much, then you can call me. I'm going to my own house and you know where it is. Thank you, Hannah said, smiling. So Hannah was smiling and she thanked Yumi. But she told herself she would not send off Yumi, however the baby cried. But Hannah was strong and she was determined that even if the baby cried, she's not going to call Yumi. Now for Hannah, the responsibilities were much more. There was an outsider who was taken care of. He had to support his, she had to support her husband and all these things, what all care the patient requires. She was there to support her husband for all that. And now the servants, the gardener, the cook, the caretaker of the children, everybody was going away. So Hannah was obviously now under pressure, under a lot of stress. And obviously the stress of keeping your enemy at your house was the biggest one, because if the police or the government comes to know, then you are in a big trouble, right? Please continue. She made the breakfast. Shubhangi, please continue.
Yes, ma'am. She made the breakfast and Sudhao helped with the children. Neither of them spoke of the servants beyond the fact that they were gone. But after Hannah had taken morning food to the prisoner, she came back to Sudhao. Why is it we cannot see clearly that we ought to do? She asked him. Even the servants see more clearly than we do. Why are we different from other Japanese?
Now, Hana, next morning, Hana made breakfast for the Englishman also, and he helped the children. Neither of them spoke to the servants beyond the fact that they were gone. But after Hana had taken morning food to the prisoner, she came back to Sudao. She came back to Sudao and she questioned her husband. The question she asked her husband was that why we are not able to come to a conclusion, what we should do. They were in a baffled state of mind. They were confused. They don't know what to do because neither things were right for them. Leaving the injured person at the shore when he was in a pathetic condition, that their conscience was not allowing. And now, when they were following their conscience, they had brought him inside the house, they had treated him, they have operated him. He's almost well now, but still there is something which is troubling them. And that something is that this man is this man is an enemy. He's an Englishman. So what to do? They have no idea at all, right? That is their confusion. So Hana here is asking her husband that why things are not clear to us, why we are not able to take a decision, why we are confused. The servants can see things very clearly. For them, it was very clear. They said that why to bring an enemy to house? Why are you so fond of curing a person that you have brought an Englishman? We know we are in a state of war with English and they are our biggest enemies. Then why are we curing them? The things were very much clear to the servants. The Hana, at this point, she questions Sudao, why things are not clear to us and what we ought to do, what we should do, right? So we find both husband and wife somewhere, they are also troubled, they are under a lot of pressure, they are tense. And yes, one major point also we are missing here. Somewhere they were also scared that one of the servants or either of the servants, they may go and report to the police or the government that they are hiding an Englishman in their house. So again, that would land them into the big trouble. Right, so all these things we have to be we need to keep in mind throughout the chapter. Right, coming back to the screen again, just a second, please. Okay, so that is Hana's question. Why are we different from other Japanese? Shubhagi, please continue from this point. Sudao did not answer.
Sudao did not answer, but a little later, he went into the room where the prisoner was and said briskly, "Today you may get up on your feet. I want you to stay up only 5 minutes at a time. Tomorrow you may try it twice as long. It would be well that you get back your strength as quickly as possible."
Continue, please.
Ma'am, please scroll down.
I have.
He saw the flicker of terror on the young man's face. That was still very pale. "Okay," the boy murmured. Evidently, he was determined to say more. "I feel I ought to thank your doctor for having saved my life." "Don't thank me too early," Sudao said coldly. He saw the flicker of terror again in the boy's eyes. Terror was unmistakable as an animal's. The scars on his neck were crimson for a moment. "Those scars, what are they?" Sudao did not ask.
Now, the man now was in a condition that he thanked the doctor. That, "Thank you for curing me. Thank you for saving my life." Right? On this, what was Sudao's response? Sudao had cured him, but still he remembered that he was his enemy. So he said that, "Today you may get up on your feet. I want you to stay up only 5 minutes at a time," because it's like gradually you overcome your injuries. So it's not safe to all of a sudden if you start walking after so bad injuries when you had suffered. "So tomorrow you may try it twice as long. It would be well that you can get back to your strength as quickly as possible." So Sudao then said that, "Do not thank me immediately. Do not thank me, because it's too early to thank me. Don't thank me too early. Perhaps Sudhao here indicated the boy that I have saved your life. But it's not that I'm your friend. It's not that I'll be saving you further also. I may hand you over to the police or to the army. So Sudhao said coldly. He saw the flicker of terror again in the boy's eyes. Terror as unmistakable as animals. The scars on his neck were crimson for a moment. So because he was scared by getting this response from Sudhao, he was scared. And there were scars on his neck which became crimson, which became red out of the fear. But Sudhao did not ask that how he got these scars. Let's continue. Shubhangi, please read two stanzas and then I'm giving you the explanation again.
Yes, ma'am. In the afternoon, the second thing happened. Hannah, working hard on an unaccustomed labor, saw a messenger come to the door in the official uniform. Her hands went weak, and she could not draw her breath. The servants must have told already. She ran to Sudhao, gasping, unable to utter a word. But by then, the messenger had simply followed her through the...
Just a second, beta. There is some issue. Continue, beta. Shubhangi, continue karo.
By then the messenger had simply followed her through the garden and there he stood. She pointed at him helplessly. Ma'am, please scroll down. What is it? He asked the messenger and then rose the man's uniform. Then Rose, seeing the man...
Shubhangi, you have missed this one. Chalo, theek hai, it's okay. What is this? Please continue.
What is this? He asked the messenger. And then Rose, seeing the man's uniform. You are to come to the palace, the man said, the old general in pain again.
Continue.
Shall I continue?
Yes, please.
Oh, Hannah breathed, is that all? All, the messenger exclaimed. Is it not enough? Indeed it is, she replied. I am very sorry.
Okay. Now, you remember in the beginning I have told you there were two reasons why Sudhao, at this time of war also when a lot of doctors were required along with the army, he was not sent along with the troops. The two major reasons was, one, Dr. Sudhao was also a scientist. So he was busy experimenting on how to remove the wounds, how to remove the wound marks, right? He was doing experiments on this. He was doing research work on this. That was one reason. And second reason was that he was treating a general. He was looking after a general, and this general could anytime be in need of medical attention or a surgery. This general has also, he was supposed to undergo a surgery also. So he could need Dr. Sudhao anytime. So because of these two reasons, he was not sent along with the army. Now, it was a time there was an army officer was there at the door, and Hannah asked him, Hannah questioned him what he requires. And at that time, he tells that general requires him, means general requires Dr. Sudhao's immediate attention. Right? So Dr. Sudhao was called by the general because maybe general was in trouble or he was in pain and he had to be treated by Dr. Sudhao. Right? Mm-hmm. Please continue, Shubhangi. We just left with 3-4 minutes. Jitna jaldi se kar sakte ho, beta, kar lo jara.
Yes, ma'am. When Sudhao came to say goodbye, she was in the kitchen but doing nothing. The children were asleep and she sat merely resting for a moment, more exhausted from her fright than from work. I thought they had come to arrest you, she said. He gazed down her anxious eyes. I must get rid of this man for your sake, he said in distress. Somehow I must get rid of him. Sudhao goes to see the general.
Continue.
Of course, the general said weakly, I understand fully, but that is because I once took a degree in Princeton, so few Japanese have.
Okay, now I'm stopping the story here. See, basically what it is, fine. Now, there was a call from the general. When the officer had come to call, to tell Hana that Dr. Sudhao is required at general's house, Hana was scared. Why was Hana scared? Because after looking at that officer person, the person coming from the army, she was scared. Perhaps somebody had informed them that they are hiding an Englishman in their house. So they were scared that they'll be caught and they'll be put behind the bars. That was the reason that why they were scared, right? When the officer tells Hana that Dr. Sudhao was called for the treatment of general, so Dr. Sudhao gets ready to go to the general space. Now, Dr. Sudhao here also realizes that the entire family, now the servants had already left, he and his wife, they were under a lot of pressure. They were really scared, right? It was a kind of a fear in which they were living in. Because anytime they'll be caught, they could be caught by the police. Anytime, if anybody informs the government or the military, they will be put behind the bars. And they will be declared as cheaters, person who cheats the country, right? So they had to take up a decision now. It was high time. Now the patient was cured. He was fine. So Dr. Sudhao had to take a decision. Now Dr. Sudhao realizes that he was going to the general, as general belonged to the army. So he would discuss this thing. He would discuss this thing with the general and he would ask for a solution from him. So he discusses the entire thing with the general. And then we are going to further read it. I'm not going to disclose the entire story yet. So we are going to see what suggestion the general takes, or what you can say, what the general offers, what help the general offers to Dr. Sudhao. That is what we are going to further read. It's a long story. It's going to take some time. So be patient, but you're going to enjoy the story because we can understand the state of mind of Dr. Sudhao and Hana, what they were going through. Very much, you know, they were like trapped. What to do and what not to do. They were patriots. They loved their country more than anything else, but they were also doctors into this noble profession.